What we have here on the left, and it's linked to all the symbols in radar screen. So for example, we will start to use some Forex symbols, British pound, USD, and there are different order settings on the right-hand side of matrix. Most important is order type auto limit stop, because it will set automatically a limit or a stop order on the bid size where you should place all your buy orders. It will shift automatically to a limit order if I go below the last price. Last price you see here in the middle with the yellow marked, and as soon as I go above the last price, it will be a stop order, because it makes no sense to place a limit order what is higher than the last price. Then it's automatically a stop order, and if you go below the price, it's a limit order. So this is the function auto limit stop. As soon as you set or placed the order here, you can easily change it with a drag and drop function, or just cancel the order so that there's no problem and an easy way to set everything what you need for buy and sell your positions. And the same or the opposite at the end on the other side of second, on the other side for the sell order, you have here a limit. Makes sense, only above the last price, and below you will place a stop order, because it makes no sense to sell with a limit order cheaper than the last price. So this is very helpful if you really work here with the prices in the matrix. Same for any stock or equity. For example, if we go here to, which one should we choose? We can choose, for example, Cisco. Same what we had for the Forex symbol. The only difference is here in the quantity. It will always start with 500. You can type every other quantity, and you will see it at the end here. So for the next time, you can easily access your quantity by just clicking in the quantity you used the last time. Very important is here the symbol shares or dollar amount, because it's possible also to place a position with a certain dollar amount. For example, for your money management, you want to place all order just with $2,000. Then this will calculate automatically how many shares you can buy or sell. For example, here for Cisco, it's 49 shares. What's $1,989? So this, yeah, it's really useful if you use for all your position sizes the same amount. And the rest, I think, is pretty easy. You can change the duration here, day and GTC, if you want to have your order valid for the next days over the over tonight. So otherwise, if you just place it with day, the order got cancelled at the end of the day when the normal session ends. For the routing system, I would always recommend to use the smart routing, but here you can even choose so EZN or your market maker where you want to place your order. And I think buy market, sell market, and trailing stop, this is pretty simple. There's no explanation needed. Only for trailing stop, you have the chance to let a trailing stop with a percentage run behind the price, or with a fixed points amount. Depends on your exit strategy. So you can use this percentage or points to exit your positions in TradeStation. As well, you can use it for opening positions, but I mean, most common is for entry positions. Then we have place OCO orders. Most needed, I think, also for exit. If I have a existing position, I can, let's have a look. I can place a limit and a stop order, and you can also choose. Even a stop order can be set as a trailing stop order. You just need to go to the button with the three dots, and there you have limit and stop market. And if I go again on this button with three dots, I can choose trailing stop or even advanced order settings like activation rule when there's certain price triggered. This should also help you to use like different exit strategies combined with a certain price. So these are the main functions for Matrix. You can also have a look at the advanced order bar. You will find this just if you click the go to view and then advanced order bar. The most interesting thing for me is the activation rule, where I can just add a price or a time when my order should be valid. For example, if I want to skip the first 30 minutes in the stock market because it's very volatile, I can just set my order that's maybe only valid after 4 p.m. In my time zone, or if you use another time zone, yeah, you have to check what's the first hour of the opening time for the market you want to trade. Same for price. You can also combine this with any other stock. For example, I can say I only want to buy Cisco if the S&P 500 ETF will be above $310, and then I can place it here. Oh, this was a little bit fast. And you see here activation rule only after 4 p.m. and the ETF's buy should be above $310. Just make sure for any next order you will place here that you uncheck this box. Otherwise, every new order will be having this activation rule, what you set here. So these are the main tools for Matrix. I think especially for intraday trading or short-term trading, it's a big benefit to have it here, other than placing it with the order bar above. If there's a stock like Netflix or Google, what's quite volatile, it makes maybe more sense to use this for, yeah, at least stocks which don't have a price and a volatile movement like we have it with Netflix here. I have to check, for example, it's taking a while to see the best bid and best ask, so it's not so simple if something is moving very fast. But you can choose all this and make all the setting with your paper trading account. You don't have to use it for the beginning in a live trading account. So just make sure you know all the important settings and how to place a buy and a sell order, and also how to exit your position. And then you would see if this is a benefit in using Matrix for TradeStation Global in combination with Interactive Broker.